Any idea about this model? What is OSI model? Just tell me, like, why we have this model? Without this model, what we cannot do, or with this model, what we can do? Okay, whole network on OSI model. Okay, developed by ISO. Okay. And specific to protocol, open system int, okay. Standardization of layered approach, okay. And okay, so first of all, what is the full form of OSI model? Open system interconnect, okay. So the full form is open system connection, right? So the full form is open system interconnection. I think the name is clear. Open system interconnection. It means the intercommunication, the communication in between two devices, two different devices. What we use OSI model. Okay. So basically, yes, developed by IBM. Okay. That is open standard. So all the devices, all the platform, they use OSI model to send the packets to each other. Let's suppose before this model, let's suppose we have a company. Okay. So this is your company A. This is your company A. Okay. And same. And let's suppose here we have company B, AB. Okay, now in the company A, what they're using, they are using, let's suppose, the iOS they're using, that is Windows, let's suppose, okay. And in the company AB, they are using Mac operating system. Okay, so right now, let's suppose we don't have this model. So what they cannot do now, right now, they cannot do the communication in between these two devices, right? So this window, this operating system will be using a different communication method, right? And same here. The Mac operating system will be using a different communication method, right? So they cannot communicate. This is just like a let's suppose these guys just understand the English, okay? And these guys in the Mac operating system, they can just understand the Chinese language, okay? So these guys cannot any communication to these guys, and same here. But now, what is the OSI model? That is a common model, right? It means after this development, what they can do a intercommunication. Okay, if we, let's suppose we don't have this model, so these devices cannot do any communication to each other, but with this model, what they can do, they will be using a common model. Let's suppose now they both knows English, okay? So what they can do now, they can communicate to each other, right? It is clear, guys? Any doubt in these things? Guys, any doubt to this point? Why we have this model, OSI model? I think that one is clear, right? Just to make the communication in between two different devices, or we can say in between two different platform, right? So this OSI model follows seven layers, right? And first of all, that is developed by IBM, correct? So what is the vendor? ISO, right? So what is ISO? Any idea? So this OSI model, this reference model, was created by ISO. Okay, that is International Organization for Standardization. Okay, So the full form is this one, International Organization for Standardization. Okay, so this OSI reference model is developed by this way, this company, and that's it about this one. Okay, now, so this OSI reference model, so it has how many layers? Any idea? 7 layers. Okay, the first layer, okay, so I'm getting some answers of physical layer, I'm getting some answers of application layers. Okay, so let me note down some layers. Okay, so let's say the first is application. Okay, and I'm getting some answers about the physical as well. Okay, so which one is first layer? The correct definition about the first layer. Okay, I'm getting application physical. Okay, basically, if you are a sender, let's suppose you are using facebook.com, okay, and you want to send a hello to your friend. Okay, so if you are sender, so the first layer will be application, right? If you are receiver, so the first layer will be physical layer. It is clear, guys? We need a medium to send. Yes, we'll discuss about this one, the medium. Okay, so first of all, what is OSI model like? How many layers here we have? We have 7 layers. The first layer will be application if you are a sender. Okay, and the first layer will be physical if you are a receiver. So basically, we always say the first layer will be application, right? Because let's suppose I'm not gonna send you a message, so how you can receive the packet, correct? So the first layer will be application layer. Okay, if we are a sender. If receiver, so yes, we can say that is physical. So let's start with the application. Okay, so guys, any doubt in this one, in these two lines, the application and the physical? Deepak, this is CCNA class, not ethical hacking. So guys, any doubt till this point, like what is application layer and not what is application layer, we'll discuss on this one. What will be the first layer? I think that one is clear, right? To all of you guys. Okay, now let's start with the first layer, that is application layer. So the definition will be the data generated by any application, or let's say we are using a web browser. Okay, so any data generated using any application, any web browser. So the data will again, like the first layer will be application layer. That means the data will start encrypting using the first layer, that is application layer, right? So how many protocols here we have, do you know? Okay, about the protocols, we will discuss in that TCP IP model. Okay, right now we will just discuss the flow of the layers and the mechanism of layers. Okay, about the protocols, we will discuss in the TCP IP model. Okay, so any doubt in this one, in this application layer? Let's suppose we are using Facebook application, we are using WhatsApp, we are using any random, any third party software. Okay, so the data, the packet, the information generated by the application or web browser or third party software, it will always start from the first layer, that is application layer, right guys? Any doubt till this point, just ask if you have any doubt. Guys, any doubt, please tell me. Identification of service, guys, we'll discuss about that one. Right now, just tell me, like, the application layer is clear or not? Okay, now, the next layer. What is next layer? Any idea, guys? Different protocols. Presentation. Okay. Okay, so the presentation layer. So what we can discuss about this one? Any idea, guys? What is this presentation layer? Okay, so the first task is encryption. If this layer is doing the encryption, so yes, can also do the decryption, right? And the format of data, okay. The compression it can do, perfect. If this layer can do the compression, so yes, can also do the decompression. And one more thing this device, this layer can do, that is encapsulation, right? If can do encapsulation, so yes, also can do decapsulation, right? Data representation and encryption, perfect, right, Anshul? Correct. So this layer will be responsible to perform the encryption, decryption, compression, decompression, and encapsulation, decapsulation. Now the task is, in what condition we can say that is doing the encryption, and in what condition we can say compression and encapsulation? Like we were discussing, like application physical, right? So if you are sender, so yes, it will be application. If you are receiver, so that will be physical. So in what condition we can say the device is doing the encryption or decryption? If you are sender or receiver, so what we can say? Any idea? Guys, any idea about this one? If you are a sender, okay, then encryption, perfect. So these things, encryption, compression, and encapsulation. So these things, if you are a sender, so what we can do, we can encrypt the data, we can the compression, we can encapsulation, right, guys? And the receiver end, that guy will do the just opposite. If you are a receiver, you can do encryption, compression, and encapsulation. Right, guys? Any doubt till this point? Now, what is encryption and what is encapsulation? Any idea, guys? Like in what, how we can explain this thing? What type of encryption that will do, or what is the encryption? What is the encapsulation? Any idea? The difference between encryption and encapsulation. Encryption is securing the data. Okay. Okay. It means the encrypted form. Let's suppose I want to say hi Neeraj, right? So we are sending hi Neeraj using, let's suppose, Facebook. Okay. So in the background, what it will do? Yes, a coded language. Correct. It will just like send. let's say I'm using like this. I'm coding this one in the encrypted form. This one. Okay. So this is a plain text, right? But once this layer, presentation layer, will receive the data, what it will do, it will encrypt using any format, using any encryption. Okay, so it will do like this. Okay, so on the wire, what I can see, I can just see this one, and the receiving device can do the decryption, right? That is clear. It means a different form of the data, correct? Yes, encryption is a form that only receiver can understand. If you know the decryption, so yes, you can also do the decryption, right? Correct. So any doubt in the encryption? Guys, any doubt? Okay, now what is encapsulation? What is encapsulation? Binding data into data, okay. Okay, so basically, what is encapsulation? To bind multiple data, multiple packets, we can say, right?
Multiple packets.
And data, we can say, into single data, or we can say single packet, right? So let's suppose we are accessing a service, or let's suppose we are accessing a website, okay, that is having 10 pages, okay? So what the device will do, the device will encapsulate 10 pages into a single page and will send it to me, right? So once I will receive the packet, what I will do, I will do decapsulation of the packet. It means from one single page, what I will get multiple pages, right? It is clear. I think this thing is clear. What is encapsulation? What is encryption, right? So guys, any doubt to this point? Encryption,
encryption.
Okay. Now, let's discuss what is compression. Now, just tell me about the compression. Okay. So this we use. To decrease the data size, correct? Let's suppose those 10 pages are having the size of 100 MB, right? So what this layer will do, this compression mechanism will just convert, let's suppose that is 100 MB pages, okay? All those 10 pages, the size is 100 MB, okay? So what it will do, let's suppose maybe it can convert the pages into 10 MB only. So this is called compression. So once the device, the receiver device will receive the data, it will do decompression and will receive those 100 MB data, right? Yeah, like WhatsApp reducing the size of that image is correct. That is perfect. Okay, so I think the presentation layer is clear, right? The encryption part, the compression, decompression, decryption, encapsulation, decapsulation. I think this one is clear, right? Just tell me if you have any doubt, just tell me. Okay, it's clear to everyone, guys. Okay, now the next layer. What is the next layer? Session. So guys, right now we're just discussing the basic things of the OSI model, okay? So once we will start TCP IP, again, we will discuss these things, okay? Like what is the main mechanism of these layers and what protocols we use in these layers, okay? Like in the application, presentation, session, okay? These are just basics of these layers. Okay, the session layer, so what this will do, this session layer, any idea? Just give me the idea, then I will explain this thing. Okay, end-to-end connection between two hosts, perfect. So, will be responsible to create a end-to-end connection. Yes, it will like... it will be responsible to set up a connection, right? will be responsible to reset the connection. And will be responsible to manage the connection, right? Now, how the device will do these things? First of all, what is this setup, reset a connection, manage a connection, and even let's suppose, okay, let me use a browser. Okay, let's suppose right now we are using 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 tabs we are using, right? So let's say I will search here google.com. Okay, I'm getting here, I will open a new tab, google.com. So right now what I have, I have two separate connection with the google.com, right? If I will do any, let's suppose I'll do search here, let's suppose JNtech Networks. Okay, so I'll just get the reply on this page, correct? If I search here the same thing, JNtech Networks, so I'll get the reply on this page, correct? And who is responsible for these things? The session layer will be responsible for these things, correct? Is that clear? So the session layer will be responsible to manage these connections, to manage these things. Okay, now in the background, how they are working? In the background, they will be using some communication type to maintain these things, okay, to maintain the connection, to reset the connection, to set up a connection. So right now what is happening here, we have created a new session, and now if I'll search new things here like CCIE, so that is maintaining the session. And then finally, if I'll shut down this, let's suppose I will do this one, okay, it means this is the reset of the session. If I'll capture the packets, I'll show you these things. If I'll capture the packets, so I can just clearly see those join, like those join message and the reset connection, like they will transfer some packets, and the maintenance as well. Okay, so we can see all of these packets. In the background, in the device, we can see what type of communication they're using. The first is simplex. Okay. The second one is half duplex. The third thing is full duplex. So in the background, they're using these things, right? So guys, any idea about this one? What is simplex? What is half duplex? What is full duplex? Just to maintain these things, just to reset the connection, just to create a new connection, to maintenance, everything. In the background, these three things are working, okay? So just give me any idea about simplex, half duplex, and full duplex. The difference between session and cookies, like both are different things. We'll discuss on that, don't worry. Right now, just tell me like what is simplex, what is half duplex, what is full duplex, because these three things will be responsible to make the communication possible in the session layer, okay? Simplex used only for one side communication, perfect. Always one side, perfect. So this simplex will always be one way communication. We cannot change the direction, right? The direction will be reserved, perfect, right? And if I'll talk about half duplex, this will be one way communication at a time, right? The direction can be changed in the half duplex, right? And the full duplex will be like two-way communication at a time, like we use, okay, like a telephone. So the telephone, the phone, they are the full duplex example, okay? In the half duplex, we can say that is walkie talkie. In the simplex, any idea guys about the simplex? What is the best example for simplex? Okay, TV, we can say. Okay, so yeah, we have simplex, we have half duplex, we have duplex. So these communication type will be responsible to make the communication possible on the session layer. Okay, so this is all about the session layer. Any doubt till this point? Guys, if these three layers are clear to all of you, then we can proceed. Just tell me, because I'm just getting the reply from two or three guys. That's it. Okay, let's continue. So till this point, and first of all, what we say to this mechanism, first of all, till this layer, we use a name, we use PDU to represent data. What is PDU? PDU is protocol data unit. Okay, so this is protocol data unit. So we never say packet, we never say any data. What we say here, so the, let's suppose we are checking the layer, right? So on the application layer, on the session layer and presentation layer and the session layer, what we say, the PDU, protocol data unit. Okay, and till the layer, till the session layer, device will not be having power to fragment the data. Okay, so till this layer, I will be having a single PDU. Okay, it is clear. Has any doubt till this point? And we cannot capture these three layers on the wire. Only LAN card will be responsible for these three layers. Okay, so only the LAN card like will be responsible for these three layers. Like the LAN card will just, the only the LAN card can see these things, right? The application layer, the presentation layer, and the session layer. Okay, I'll repeat this again, no problem. So this layer, first of all, to represent the data, we just say protocol data unit. This is the technical name of this data. Okay, that is clear, Arvind? The protocol data unit. So this is the technical name here for these layers. Okay, now till this session, till the session layer, device will not be having power to fragment the data. It means till this date, till this session layer, the data will not be fragmented. Okay, that is clear. Arvind, that is clear to you? Okay, now the next line, we cannot capture these three layers on the wire. It means whenever the device, whenever my LAN card, because at the last, what is the mechanism? The LAN card will be responsible to place the data on the wire, correct? So my LAN card will be responsible to place the data on the wire. So what we say, these three things we cannot see in the layers. In what we can say, whenever I will capture the link, okay, I will show the things. So at that time, we cannot see the application layer, we cannot see the presentation layer, we cannot see the session layer. What we can see, the transport layer we can see. Okay, so these three things we cannot see, these three layers we cannot see on the wire. So whenever I will capture a link, so what I can see, I can just see the other layers. Okay, it's like a yes, we can say yes, only the LAN card will be responsible, or we can say only LAN card can convert the data into these layers. Okay, only LAN card, we cannot see, we can just see the data, that's it. But we cannot identify, or we cannot convert the data into those layers. Only the LAN card will be having power to convert those things, okay, into the application layer, the data, the presentation layer, the session layer. Okay, is that clear? Okay, so what we have done, we have done application layer, we have done presentation layer, and we have done the session layer. Okay, so this is all about these three layers. Any doubt till this point, guys? If you have, I can explain again, no problem, just tell me. These three things are clear? Okay, now let's start the next layer. So yes, the next layer is transport layer. Perfect. So this layer, just give me any idea, guys, if you know about this layer, then I will start explaining. end-to-end connection segmentation, connectivity, TCP, UDP protocols, okay, end-to-end connection, reassemble data segments and reassemble. Okay, the line segments and reassemble, that is perfect. That is exact line, perfect. Okay, how the data to be delivered, okay. So basically the definition, we can say this layer will be responsible to not fragment, segment, to segment the data and reassemble into a single stream. Okay, so this layer will be responsible to segment the data and to reassemble into a single stream. Okay, guys. And this layer will be the very first layer where the data will be segmented. Clear? So this layer will be very first layer to where the data will be segmented. It means once the transport layer will receive the data, it will start segmenting the packets. Okay. And what we say here, segments. Okay. So here, this is your segment PDU. Okay. So whenever I will see any data, in the transport layer. So what we say, we cannot say data. What we can say segment PDU. Okay. Is that clear? Okay. So on this layer, we have two protocols, right? So one protocol is TCP, one protocol is UDP. So these two protocols will be, what is the work of PDU? PDU is just a name, right? Let's suppose right now we are using a software. So the name is Zoom. Correct? Guys, can you hear me? Everyone, it's clear to all of you? Okay. Now, so what is PDU? Basically, PDU is the name, segment PDU, protocol data unit. When we are using a software that is Zoom. So the what is the name of the software is Zoom, correct? We can also use Cisco WebEx. So the name is Cisco WebEx, correct? Same here, the name of the packet is here, that is segment PDU. We never say packet, we never say data. What we say here, segment PDU on this layer. So whenever I will receive anything here on the transport layer, what will be the name? That is segment PDU. Okay. Is that clear? Okay. So TCP, UDP, these two protocols will be responsible to make connection end to end. Okay. And basically these two protocols will be using a mechanism to identify the services. Okay. How they will identify, we'll discuss, don't worry. Okay. PDU is the data unit being called referred. Yes, that is correct. So PDU is just a name. Okay. On the transport layer, we say segment. Now on the third layer, like the fifth layer, that is network layer. So we say packet PDU, right? That's it. So this layer, these two protocols will be using a mechanism to identify the services. Yes, definitely. So now these two protocols will be using some feature that is port number. Okay. So what is port number? Let's suppose port number is like the service type will identify the service type. Okay. Let me take an example. Let's suppose we have two PC that is connected via a global service provider. Okay. And now the address this device is using, that is 10.0.0.1. Let's suppose. So I think all of you are aware with these things, right? The IP address, the MAC address, correct? A sound knowledge, that's it. Because we'll discuss, don't worry, in the detail. Just a sound knowledge. Because whenever I will connect a PC, I will connect a PC in a network or a phone. So that will receive an IP address, right? Okay. And let's suppose they are using 20.0.0.2. Okay, so this PC is having IP address 10.0.0.1 with MAC address A. And this device is using a MAC address that is B. And let's suppose we have some pages. Okay, so one page here we have that is HTTP. One we have HTTPS. Okay, so same on this page, what we have a Facebook page. Same here, what we have a Facebook page. Okay, now, so for this one, the port number is reserved, that is 80. Okay, for this one, the port number is reserved, that is 443. Okay, so you have to cram these things, the HTTP port number, the HTTPS port number, that is 443, port number 80. Now, let's suppose we don't have these kinds of port numbers. So what will happen here? Let's suppose this user want to access 20.0.0.2 and what he want to access, HTTP. Okay, and in HTTP, it will include facebook.com. Okay, in the second one, 20.0.0.2, it want to access HTTPS and want to access the same facebook.com. So whenever they will send the packet out and a PC will never use these things to understand the concept, right? They will be using some numbers, correct? They cannot understand the name, right? So let's suppose once this device will receive the data, control C, V. So they will not receive, let's suppose these things. Okay, and they will not receive, they cannot understand the HTTPS, they cannot understand. Okay, so they will receive these things like in the first packet, they will receive the facebook.com. In the second packet, they will receive the facebook.com. Port number is like hotel number. Yeah, hotel, perfect. Okay, so now, whenever this device will receive the data, will receive these two requests, will be confused what service I have to transfer, right? So sometimes it can transfer the HTTP page or maybe it can transfer the HTTPS, right? So at that time, the device will not be able to give the reply to exact services, right? So at that time, that will be using some port number. So whenever this device will originate the request, okay, it will also include the port numbers 80 and 443, right? So once a device will receive these things, so they will just check these things, right? So let's say they are getting a packet with port number 80 and with port number 443, right? So whenever they will receive, they will identify, okay, we are getting a packet with port number 80 with port number 443. So what I have to do for the port number 80, I have to give this page, and for port number 443, what I have to do, I have to give this service. Okay. So I think this port number concept is clear. So basically these port number will be using to identify the services. Okay. So the device will be using these port numbers to identify the services. Is that clear? Any doubt till this point? Okay. One more thing here. So now I'll explain the other task here. Again, the another thing. So right now, all of these things will be in the destination, correct? So let's suppose the port number are fixed or random. So some port numbers are fixed, okay, and some are random. So let me show you one thing. All if you can this PDF file. So these are the port numbers in the TCP UDP. Okay, so as I told you, for the HTTP, this is the port number 80. Okay, for the HTTPS, this is the port number 443. Okay, so these are the port numbers that they use. Okay, so here you can check for the chat, for the encryption, for the gaming, malicious, peer-to-peer streaming. So these are the port numbers that they use for all the services. Okay. Any doubt till this point? Javir, I think this is clear, right? the fixed port numbers and the random port numbers. Okay. Now, the next thing. So these things will be in the destination, correct? So in the destination, port number will always be fixed, always, okay? But in the source port number, it will be random. Okay, so now the destination port number will always be a fixed port number, and the source port number will be a random port number. Okay, now we'll discuss on the source port number. Okay, so this thing we have done in the source port. Now let's suppose we are not using source port number, so what will happen? Okay, so the same diagram I will be using. So these things that will carry in the destination, and let's suppose we do not have the source port number mechanism. So what will happen here? Whenever this device will give the reply, so this device will get two replies, right? Let's suppose on this page we are using a HTTP page only. Okay, on the another page I'm getting a HTTPS. So at the time the device will confuse, the receiving device will confuse from on which page I have to receive HTTPS, on which page I have to receive HTTP, right? So these port numbers will again responsible for this connection also. Okay, now what will happen here? Whenever the device will generate these packets, so the 80 and the 443 will be the destination port number, correct? Now the source port number, so let's say the IP is, the source IP will be 10.0.0.1. In the second packet it will be 10.0.0.1, right? In the HTTP, let's suppose the source port number they are using, that is that will be random port number, a higher port number, 43434. Okay, and they want to access HTTP, so the port number will be 80. So this is the destination port number and this is the source port number, right? And in the second services, let's suppose they are using 53434. Okay, and the destination port number will be 443. So once the device will get reply, so this device will give the reply, right? Source will, it will put 20002, destination it will, source port number it will put 0. So at the time of reply, so whenever the client will send a request, will send a request. So at that time, the destination port will be fixed. But once the device will give reply, the source port number will be fixed. Okay. Now the destination will be 43434. And same here for the other services. 443 will be the source and 43434 will be the destination. Okay. So again, that's depend on your sender and receiver. If you are a sender, so the destination port will be fixed. If you are a receiver, so the source port will be fixed always. Okay. Any doubt till this point? So some are fixed port numbers, so and the source port number will be random. Okay, so in this mechanism, in this layer, in the transport layer, they will always be using these port numbers just to identify the services. Okay, and this layer, oh yes, here it will be 53. That is my mistake. Okay, this will be 53. Yeah. So this layer, so okay guys, hindi mein samjhaya to mai, so koi issue nahi hai. So guys dekho, abhi humne yahan pe kya kiya, like the destination port number humne use kare kaise, like jis service ko identify karne ke liye, to humne yahan pe kya kiya, humne use kare port number 80, port number 443 humne use kiya kis cheez ke liye, just to identify the service, correct? कि मेरा पैकेट गया किसके पास, इस सर्वर के पास, और जब उसने रिसीव किया उसने क्या किया, आइडेंटिफाई किया इन चीजों को, किस चीज से, इन पोर्ट नंबर से. अगर मेरे पास यहाँ पे नहीं होते ये पोर्ट नंबर्स, सो वहां पे इशू क्या आता, वो चेक नहीं कर पाते किस चीज को, सर्विस को, कि कौन सर्विस देनी है. बिकॉज अगर बात करूं मैं अदर सर्विसेज की, राइट, सो किसी का पोर्ट नंबर होगा 23, किसी का होगा पोर्ट नंबर 53, राइट. सो उस टाइम पे क्या होगा, डिवाइस विल नेवर आइडेंटिफाई दीज थिंग्स, करेक्ट, वो रिकॉग्नाइज नहीं कर पाएगी कि मुझे सर्विस एक्चुअल में क्या देनी है. बिकॉज every time destination kya hoga 20002, and let's suppose is device ke paas 10 services hain, okay,
So वहां पे port number का होना जरूरी है. Okay, that is mandate. Okay, अगर नहीं होंगे port numbers, so device ना कभी name नहीं पढ़ पाएगी. कि let's suppose आप HTTP कर रहे हो, आप HTTPS कर रहे हो, आप कोई और सर्विस यूज कर रहे हो, किसी और चीज को यूज कर रहे हो, DNS सर्विस आप यूज कर रहे हो. ओके, सो जो डिवाइस होगी कभी आपको आइडेंटिफाई नहीं कर पाएगी इन चीजों के लिए. ओके, बट यस, अगर आपके पास पोर्ट नंबर है, सो द डिवाइस विल बी एबल टू रिकॉग्नाइज दीज थिंग्स, कि उसके पास क्या है, क्या नहीं है, क्या सर्विस देनी है उसे, और रिप्लाई कैसे करना है, राइट. सो जब एक सेंडर पैकेट सेंड करेगा नेबर के पास, राइट, एक रिक्वेस्ट सेंड करेगा, सो हमेशा जो सोर्स पोर्ट होगा वो क्या होगा, रैंडम होगा, रैंडमली चूज होगा, बट द डेस्टिनेशन will always be fixed. मतलब जो डेस्टिनेशन जाएगा वो क्या रहेगा, हमेशा फिक्स रहेगा. अगर लेट्स सपोज मैं यहाँ यूज करता हूँ एक सर्विसेज किस चीज की, लेट्स सपोज मैंने यूज किया एक सर्विस टेलनेट की, राइट. सो वहां पे डेस्टिनेशन पोर्ट नंबर क्या होगा, दैट विल बी 23. सो जब वो रिसीव करेगा डेस्टिनेशन डिवाइस, जब रिसीव करेगी, सो वो चेक करेगा कि जो मेरे पास पैकेट्स आ रहे हैं, लेट्स सपोज 50 पैकेट आए उसके पास, डेस्टिनेशन क्या है, सेम एग्जैक्टली. वो किस चीज को आइडेंटिफाई, किस चीज को यूज करेगा, आइडेंटिफाई करने के लिए पोर्ट नंबर को ही यूज करेगा सर्विस को आइडेंटिफाई करने के लिए, राइट. जिस लाइक रूम नंबर, कि मैं एक होटल में गया, मैंने वहां चेक किया, फाइनली रूम्स वहां काफी सारे हैं, डेस्टिनेशन भी सेम है, 10 जने आ रखे हैं वहां पे. अब वो कैसे आइडेंटिफाई करेंगे कि कौन सा रूम किसका है, सो फाइनली दे विल चेक द रूम नंबर. सो दिस पोर्ट नंबर्स विल बी लाइक अ रूम नंबर ऑलवेज. ओके सूरज, ये चीज क्लियर है आपको? सो फाइनली हमें क्या चाहिए, यहाँ पे एक पोर्ट नंबर चाहिए, राइट, जो पोर्ट नंबर आइडेंटिफाई करेगा इन चीजों को, कि एक्चुअल में क्या सर्विस मुझे देनी है या कौन सा रूम मुझे चूज करना है यूजिंग रूम नंबर्स, राइट. सो दैट इज जस्ट लाइक रूम नंबर. ओके, एंड द सोर्स पोर्ट नंबर वो हमेशा क्या रहेगा, एक रैंडम पोर्ट नंबर रहेगा. ओके ओके गाइस, एनी डाउट टू दिस पॉइंट इन द ट्रांसपोर्ट लेयर, इफ यू हैव एनी डाउट जस्ट टेल मी. एंड दिस लेयर विल बी द वेरी फर्स्ट लेयर वेयर द डेटा विल बी सेगमेंटेड. ओके, द फर्स्ट लेयर will be application or physical. So this is the first layer just to segment the data. That's it. Okay, we cannot say the first layer will be transport layer, but just to segment data, the data, this layer will be responsible, and this layer will be the first layer who will start segmenting the data. Okay, the other layers will like also do the segment and fragments. Okay, but this layer will be the first layer to do the task. Okay, any doubt guys till this point? It's clear to all of you. Okay, so basically right now we are using two things, right? One is TCP, one is UDP, correct? So TCP and UDP. So basically these two things are like, we have two things here, right? We'll be able to see all these practically, yes, 100%. So once I will start the TCP model, okay. So at that time I will be using some services, some application layer protocols. So at that time I will show you everything, everything I'll show you, okay? Each and every layer, the how we can capture the packets, everything I'll show you, okay? So in the TCP, first of all, the TCP is a reliable protocol, right? The UDP is not reliable. So guys, can you just tell me what is reliable, what is not reliable, and why this protocol is not reliable? Just tell me, like, what is reliability, like why in the TCP we have this reliability? TCP is secure, UDP is not secure. About the security, that is a different thing. Okay, acknowledgement. First of all, yes, the acknowledgement. So in the TCP, yes, we have acknowledgement, but in the UDP, we do not have any acknowledgement, right? Any kind of acknowledgement, never. Okay. So in the case of TCP, yes, we have acknowledgement. In the case of UDP, we do not have any acknowledgement. Okay. UDP does not care whether the data has been delivered or not. Yes, perfect. So in the TCP, we will get acknowledged definitely. So that will check everything, the data is delivered or not. So UDP will never check this thing. The data has been delivered or not. Okay, that will never check, right? Okay, so that is due to three-way handshake, correct? We can see that we'll be having a three-way handshake. So about the three-way handshake, we'll discuss in the case of TCP model. Okay, I will show you all the three-way handshake, how they will do this three-way handshake. Okay, we'll explain this thing in the TCP IP. Connection oriented, connectionless. Okay, perfect. And do we have any other difference? Just guess, just tell me. Okay, so which one is connection oriented and which one is connectionless? TCP is oriented. Okay, perfect. TCP is oriented and perfect. So about the connection oriented and connectionless, we'll discuss in the TCP IP because these are the technical words we'll discuss. Don't worry. So the connection oriented, connectionless, and the three-way handshake we'll discuss in the TCP IP. Okay. And okay, so you're saying like UDP is fast and the TCP is slow. Okay. So this is a slow and this is fast. Okay. I think that is correct and I think that is not correct. Okay. So let's discuss on the slow and fast. Just tell me one thing. Whenever we use facebook.com, so what that will be using? UDP or TCP? TCP, correct. So if Facebook is using TCP, okay, can you please just tell me like Facebook is slow or fast? Fast, right? So why we can say that is slow? No, that is not slow, right, Ajay? Whenever I will access a Facebook, let's suppose I'm having a connection. No, sometimes no, that's everything depends on your speed. Let's suppose you are having a speed of 1 GB per second. Okay, so in that condition, if you are using a TCP, if you are using a UDP, in that case everything will be fast. Okay, so this mechanism of slow and fast, that is a different thing. Okay, that is not, that's not depend on your speed. So if you are having a slow speed, so at the time UDP will be slow 100%. Okay, if you are using a speed of 1 GB per second, so at that time both TCP and UDP, that will be fast. Okay, so Arvind, you're saying that UDP is fast as it does not check and no acknowledgement. Okay, that is fine. But again, let's suppose we are using a 1 GB connection, right? And I want to access Facebook, I want to access YouTube.com. So I think that is too fast, right? Within milliseconds, like I can access Facebook. Within milliseconds, I can access Google, even YouTube also, right? So if we will talk about the speed, right? So we cannot say the TCP is slow, the UDP is fast. Okay, both protocols, if let's suppose we have a speed of 1 GB per second, so at that time both protocols will be fast. If let's suppose we are using 1 MB per second only, so at that time maybe both protocols will be slow. Okay, so this slow and the fast will not be depend on the speed. Okay. Okay, TCP header is 20 byte. We'll discuss about the headers in the TCP model. Okay, not now. Right now we're just discussing the basics. TCP provide error control. Okay, so that is a different part. Right now we are discussing the slow and fast. So we have to clear this thing, why we call this slow and fast. If someone asks, let's suppose an interview, if someone asks, can you explain slow and fast? So if you will say that TCP is slow due to the speed or these things, no, that will be wrong always. Okay, so guys, any idea, just tell me. Because if I'll be using a speed of 1 GB or 10 MB or 1 MB or 100 KB, so at that time this will speed will be slow for both, speed will be fast for both, right? In what condition we can say TCP is slow, UDP is fast? Any idea now? Okay, let me explain you. So first of all, if I will be having a good speed, okay, the data transfer speed will be fast in the TCP also. Because if I will access YouTube here, okay, so I'm accessing the data of the YouTube server, right? So at that time, yes, I will receive the packet with a good speed, correct? Within milliseconds I can receive the packet, correct? Due to acknowledgement, no, never. UDP is fast, that is fast, no problem, due to acknowledgement. But again, TCP is also fast. In what condition we can say TCP is slow? In what condition we can say TCP is fast, UDP is fast? Let me explain you. Let's suppose I will draw two diagrams, okay, just to explain these things. So right now we are discussing the fast and slow concept. Okay. This is your 10.0.0.1 and this is your Facebook server, or let's suppose YouTube, you are watching some videos. Okay, this is your router 1, this is your router 2. I will explain what is router, what are switches. Okay, so these things we'll discuss, don't worry. Maybe it's because of how receiver the capacity of it. No guys, the windowing mechanism that will be same for TCP and UDP for both. Okay, TCP will be faster than UDP. It's depend on, never guys, I'll explain, don't worry, I'll explain. Okay, so I think the diagram is clear, right? We have two devices, okay, and R1, R2. So this is the first case, okay. So in the first case, I will explain you the TCP mechanism. Okay, here I will explain you TCP. Okay, in the second case, I will explain you UDP, okay. So in the first case, let's suppose we are using two routers, and they want to form the neighborship. So first of all, R1, R2 will form the neighborship, right or wrong? Same in this case. So let's suppose they are using a TCP protocol to form the neighborship. Okay. And same here, in the case of UDP, first of all, they will try to form the neighborship. Okay. Now, so whenever they will try to form the neighborship, at that time only, this will be slow, okay, and this will be fast. So in the case of TCP, what they will do to form the neighborship, this device will send a packet first of all. Okay, so the device R2 will give the acknowledge of that packet and will also send a packet to the neighbor, right? Again, R1 will give the reply. So first of all, these devices have to complete this mechanism, okay, and this is called three-way handshake. We'll discuss on this one, okay, how they will do this thing. Okay, so R1 will send a packet out, R2 will also give the reply, the acknowledge it will give, and then again R2 will send a packet out, R1 has to give the reply, the acknowledge, right? And after this one, they will form the full neighborship. Okay, is that clear? And same here, what they will do in the UDP, it will send a packet out, it will send a packet out, and that's it. They will never give any knowledge, right? And the neighborship will be in the full state. Okay, so in this condition, in the case of UDP, the neighborship will be in the milliseconds, right? In the case of TCP, maybe they will be using 1 second or 2 second. Okay, so at the time of full neighborship, in the case of forming neighborship, we can say TCP is slow and UDP is fast. Okay, so only in the case of neighborship. So once, first of all, at the first time only, they will form the neighborship, right? So once they will start forming the neighborship, so yes, at that time the TCP will be slow, the UDP will be fast. But if both are having neighborship, let's suppose in the TCP, in the UDP we have a neighborship, so at that time that doesn't matter, the speed, the slow and the fast, right? If we have the both users have 1 GB/s speed, okay, so the speed to access the YouTube will be fast in both TCP and UDP. Okay guys, what is MTU? We'll discuss in the layer 3, okay? Oh, sorry, in the network layer, okay? Don't worry. Asif, just tell me, if you haven't doubt, I can explain. Just tell me, is that clear? Asif? Okay, so always, once the routers will try to form the neighborship, okay? So at that time, the TCP will be slow, the UDP will be fast, but once they have the full neighborship, so they will not be slow, they will not be fast, everything will depend on the speed, okay? So this is all about the slow and fast speed, okay? If someone asks about this thing, so you can explain like this, okay? So guys, just tell me, any doubt till this point? Shubham, any doubt? Just tell me if you're in doubt. It's clear to all of you guys. So whenever like you will be, okay. Guys, any doubt? Okay. Yes, Shubham, if you haven't doubt, just tell me. The reason you coded here to explain the slow and neighborship because of more step and acknowledge on the same will be application in normal data stream. Now again, that's depend. Let's suppose if you're using a, even any application, okay, if that application in the background that is using the TCP connection, so that will be slow. If in the background that will be using UDP, that will be fast, okay? So the application, that doesn't matter, okay? What will matter, the TCP and UDP, only the time of neighborship. If they are using TCP or UDP, so they will be slow and fast. But once you have the connection, the full connection, end-to-end connection, so that doesn't matter, okay? Everything will depend on your speed. Live streaming data, UDP, yes, definitely live streaming our data, they use UDP, yes. But again, that doesn't matter, like you have slow or fast, right? Only in the case of neighborship, that will be slow, that will be fast. Once you have the neighborship, that doesn't matter what is slow, what is fast, right? Everything will be depend on your speed. Okay. Rohan, Nikhil, any doubt? Okay, perfect. And about the flow control, about the windowing, we will discuss in the case of TCP IP model, not here, okay? So right now, today, we are just discussing the basics, okay? Because first of all, we need to like learn the basics, and then if we know the basics, so we can learn the TCP IP models, okay? So guys, so we have done the transport layer. If you have any doubt, just tell me. How will we do all the practical exist? Guys, I will provide you all the softwares if possible, okay? So you can install the software in your laptop and you can start the practical, no problem, okay? Okay, so now, the next layer is network layer. Guys, the packet tracer, I will never recommend the packet tracer, never, okay? So just try to use your JNS3 always, okay, to do all the practicals. So you will be having the exact output in the JNS3, okay? EvenG, no guys. EvenG you can use for the switches only, okay? Okay, let's start the network layer. The network layer. So basically here in this layer will be responsible to send the data between different networks, okay? It means which device we'll be using. So on this, in this layer, what we use routers and layer 3 switches, okay? So what are the layer 3 switches, we'll discuss, don't worry, okay? In the future, not now. So in this layer, we will be using routers, we will be using layer 3 switches. So only these two devices will be responsible to do the forwarding. And these two devices can just check network layer to do the forwarding. Okay, it means they will be using destination IP address to send the packet out to another device. Okay, any doubt till this point? So on this layer, the routers will be using the destination IP address to send the packet out to another device. Okay, now so let's discuss in the deep. So whenever a device receive a data, device, it means the router or layer 3 switch, first task what it will do. First of all, it will remove layer 2 header. Okay, we'll discuss what is layer 2 header in the future. Okay, so first of all, it will remove layer 2 header. Okay, the second task what it will do, it will try to find best interface, best path for the destination. Okay, and once it find a path, a best path, so it will send the packet out. It will add a new header, it will add a new L2 header and will send the packet out to the interface. Is it clear? What is layer 3 header? Yes, this is your network layer. So in the network layer, that will add your layer 3 header. Okay, so if I talk about layer 2 header, layer 3 header, so we always say the network layer and the other layer, that is data link layer. Okay, so layer 3 header, we'll discuss what will be what we will put in the layer 3 header. Okay, don't worry. So about the headers, we will discuss in the TCP IP model. While sending it, user, yes, it uses a layer 3 header always. So in this case, we always say this is a layer 3 header. Yes, what is a packet? So whenever the device will do what we can say, let's suppose the network layer will receive the segment PDU on this layer. So on this layer, what we say, we say packets. If I'm saying packet, it means I'm talking about the network layer. Okay, so on the layer, on the transport layer, we say segment PDUs. Here what we say, packets. Okay, is that clear, Deepak? Okay, so about the layer 3 header, about the layer 2 header, we'll discuss in the TCP IP model. Okay, not here. So whenever a device will receive a data, first of all, it will remove the layer 2 header. It will find the best path for the destination IP address. Okay, for the destination IP address. And once it find a best path, so it will add a layer 2 header, new layer 2 header, and will send the packet out to the interface. Okay. Okay, so we also call here this as packet. Okay, so any doubt in this one, guys? And on this layer, in this layer, we can also set the priority to the data. Okay, the router, Vinay, you are saying like the number 0.3 router will add the layer 3. No, it will never add. A router cannot do any changes to the layer 3 header, never. It can just change the, it can just replace the layer 2 header. The router will not be having power to change the layer 3 header, never. Look here, what I have told you, it will just remove the layer 2. It will never remove the layer 3, okay? Who can remove the layer 3 header? Only the end device can remove the layer 3 header, not the routers, never, okay? So it will just add the layer 2 header, not the layer 3 header, okay? Header, that is just like an envelope of the data. let's suppose you want to write a letter to your friend. Okay. So at that time, your envelope will be like a header. Okay. So on the header, like on the envelope, you will be having your home address, your destination address. So that is just like a header for the envelope. Okay. For your like letter. So headers will be having only the overview of the packet. Okay. From where it is getting the packet, from where it has to send the packet out. Okay. What is the packet type? Everything. Okay. Vinay, is that clear? Your point is clear about the layer 3 header. Okay. So network layer uses logical addressing. Yes, always. We'll be using logical addressing. Yes. So what is logical addressing? Those your IP addresses are your logical addressing. Okay. So in this layer, we can also set the priority to the data. It means, let's suppose you are sending a voice traffic, okay, and you are sending a data traffic. Okay, so at the time, what you want, that the voice traffic should go first and the device can send the data traffic later, correct? So at that time on the router, we can set the priority, and this is the part of quality of service. So in the new CCNA, yes, we have this quality of service, but we will discuss this one after the switching, after the routing part. Okay. In the routing part, we will discuss, and the end of routing part, we will discuss quality of services, how we can set a priority, how we can set quality of services in the real IP packet. Okay. I will show you everything, how you can really send a packet with priority. Okay. It means, let's suppose you're working in an organization. Okay. What do you want? You want to set the most priority to your data. So yes, you can set. Okay. What will be the size of a packet? Okay. So that's depend on the MTU. Okay. Packet on packet size on L3 will depend on the MTU. What is MTU? Maximum transmission unit, but only on layer 3. Okay. So by default is 1500. Okay. So by default, so whenever a device will try to send a packet out, okay, on the layer 3. Okay. So at the time, it will just create a packet with a maximum size of 1500. Let's suppose I'm getting a packet of 3000 bytes. Okay. So at the time, the device will break the packet in two parts. One is 1500, other another will be having 1500. Okay. Is that clear? The size of the packet, Deepak. Okay. So in future, we will discuss how we can change in the routing part. We will discuss how we can change the MTU. Okay. And we'll discuss how we can set the priority using quality of services in the packet. Basically, we have 3 bits here reserved for this one. Okay. So 3 bits are reserved. Okay. To perform the same task. 3 bits, it means you will be having 8 options to set the priority. So we'll discuss in the quality of services. Okay. In bytes or MB. So in bytes always. So this size is MTU 1500 bytes always. Okay. Any doubt to this point? So guys, any doubt till this point, like in the network layer? Almost we have done about the network layer. And the router will always check the routing table to find the best path always, okay? So what is routing table? We'll discuss in the, that is a routing table. Basically, a router will be, will maintain a table for all the destination IP address, and will maintain that thing in the routing table. That's it, okay? So our device will always check the routing table to find the best path. Always. Okay. Any doubt to this point? And how the router will like take the decision, we'll discuss. Okay. Finally, what if we decrease the size of MTU? No, no problem. You can decrease the size. Okay, but number of packets will be more at that time. Let's suppose you have configured the size to 1000 bytes and I'm getting a packet of 3000 bytes. So at that time, the device will break the data into three parts. That's it. Okay. In the communication, that will not cause any issue, never. Okay. So guys, any doubt till this point in the network layer? Okay, so what is the next layer? Data. Okay, data link, correct. So the next layer is data link layer. Okay, so this data link layer, so what this will do, first of all, we have two sub layers here. Okay, the first one is sub layer. Okay, the second one is LLC sub layer. Okay, so what this sub layer will do, so this will be responsible to place the data on the wire. So last day we have discussed FIFO, remember? FIFO. This is first in, first out, right? So this layer will be responsible, this sub layer, max sub layer, will be responsible to place the data on the wire always. Okay. Is that clear? I think this one is clear, FIFO. Last time, the last day, we have done this thing, the FIFO. First in, first out, right? So whenever a device will receive a packet, so it will send first out the data, right? Okay. Now what is LLC sublayer? This layer will be responsible. Will be responsible to set the flow control, okay, for the error detection, okay, and to encapsulate layer 3 header to layer. Okay, so this layer will be responsible for the flow control, for the error detection, and for the encapsulate of the layer 3 header to layer 2. Okay. And in the LLC, it will add source and destination episodes. Okay, so this layer will be responsible for all the tasks. Only the max sub layer will be responsible to place the data on the wire, and that will be using this mechanism FIFO. So by default on the interface, I will show you this thing, by default on the interface that support FIFO. Okay. So these things I will show you how we can change. Okay, again, that is a part of collaborative services. Okay, so in the collaborative service, I will show you how we can change this FIFO also. Okay, we can change this FIFO. We can take the decision on other parameters also. Okay, by default, this is a parameter. We have three parameters. Okay, so the first parameter is FIFO. So by default, our interface will take the decision using FIFO, first in, first out. But yes, we can change this behavior. Okay, it control error detection. So what it will correct the error. So we'll it will not correct the error. It will just check the error. If it will find any error, it will drop the packet. If not, it will receive the packet. Okay. Only at the layer 4, in the TCP layer, it will check that thing and will again try to get the packet again. Okay. So it will just check the packet. Okay. And will drop the packet if we'll be having any issues in the packet. Okay. This layer will not be responsible to request the packet again. Only the TCP will be responsible to get the packet again, to request the packet again, but not this layer. Okay, Deepak. Any doubt to this point? Flow control in LLC. Okay, so any doubt in this one? Okay, if you're talking about the, what is frame? On this layer, we say this frame, okay? So in the like network layer, what we say the packet. Here we say the frame, okay? Will it discard whole packet if packet has small? Yes, it will discard, yes. On the layer 2, it will remove the packet, yeah. It will discard the packet, yes, definitely. Because the device will not be having capability to receive the packet with errors, right? So at that time, it will not receive. And how the device will check the error, we'll discuss. Okay, I will show you how the device will check the errors. So those things we'll discuss in the case of TCP/IP model, okay? So what mechanism it will be using to check the errors, everything we'll discuss. Today, we are just discussing the basics, okay? So guys, any doubt till this point? Okay. So on this layer, what we have, okay, do you know guys, like on this layer, what device we use? Switch, hub, what is the purpose of flow control? Okay, basically the flow control is a part of layer 4, but here, this just used to control the flow. Let's suppose, basically, as I told you, right now we are explaining the flow control, okay, as if as you ask. Okay, so this layer, the MAC sub layer will be responsible to put the data on the wire, okay, but before that LLC will do a work. What it will work, finally, whenever we send the packet out to the link, okay, so the form will be 0 and 1, right or wrong? As if, so whenever at last, finally, I will send the packet out to the link, okay, so at that time, I will be having 0 and 1s, 0 and 1s, okay. So at the time, just to place carefully 0 and 1, 0 and 1, they will be using this flow control. That's it. Okay. The flow control of the bits and that's it. 0 and 1s. Okay. This is the flow control. Is that clear, Asif? Okay. Let's suppose, I will explain this again. Let's suppose we have this name and we have, let's suppose this name. Okay. So the binary conversion, the 0-1's conversion is 0110, like this is the conversion, okay, of this name. And for this one, the conversion is just like this one, okay. So whenever the device will place the data on this wire, okay, so that will check. First of all, it will check the flow of these packets, okay. First of all, it will send the first one, 0101000101, okay. Then it will maintain a gap and then it will send 11100111, okay. So like this, I'm saying the flow control, okay? The device, whenever it will send the, and basically this gap will depend on your speed, okay? Let's suppose we have two car, okay? So the car number one, okay, and the car number two, okay? So they both are having a same speed, okay? So let's suppose this car is running on 45 kilometer per hour, same, okay? So once they will come on the highway, okay, let's suppose we have single way road, okay. So if both are having the same speed, okay, so these cars will never collide, right? Which type of flow control? This type of flow control, okay, as if they are checking the speed, okay. So if the driver will come on the single way road, one way road, okay. So if the speed is 45 kilometer per hour, okay, so at that time, the second car should be on the same speed, okay. So this type of flow control, this layer will check, okay, and will be responsible for these things, okay. And in the, if I'll talk about the layers, so that will be in the megahertz, okay. So that is 5 megahertz. So on this speed, the device will start sending the bits into on the wire, okay. Asif, is that clear? The flow control on this layer. What is in the 802? Okay, that is a standard. So once I will start the TCP/IP model, I will show you like what is 802.1D or these things I will show you, okay? That is a standard of the packets, okay? No, not on the link speed. That is a different thing, okay? I'm not seeing the link speeds. 5 megahertz is not a link speed, okay? That is the speed of data, that's it, on the wire. So whenever I will I will start placing the data on the wire, I will start placing the bits into on the link, okay? The speed will be 5 meg. That is the difference in between two cars, let's suppose, okay? So this speed will be the difference here, okay? 5 megahertz. So once I will send another, so I will wait for 5 megahertz second, and then I will send another. Then again 5 megahertz seconds, then I will send another, okay? Like this. Is that clear, Nikhil? Okay. So that is a time gap between two packets, okay? So guys, any doubt to this point? Okay, I asked like which device we use on this layer, on the data link layer. Just tell me the device's name. Switches, hub, okay, and any other device? Okay, the hub is the wrong answer. Even the repeater, okay? So on this layer, on data link layer, we use switches and routers. Sorry, switches and bridges only, okay? Only these two things we use, these two devices we use on the data link layer, okay? Because these devices will be having power to send the data using MAC address. Okay. Is that clear? So this layer will be responsible to send the data using the MAC addresses. It means once a device will receive a packet, it will check the layer 2 frame, or we can say it will check the MAC address to send the packet out, right? Correct. So the switches and the bridges will only be responsible to check the frame only, okay? They cannot check the layer 3 header, never, okay? And if I'll talk about the physical layer, last layer, so this layer will be responsible. So this layer will be responsible to handle bits only, okay? And hub we use in this case, okay? So on this layer, what we use a hub device, okay? Hub works on the bits, and hub is a device that can only read the bits, that cannot read the layer 2, that cannot read the layer 3, never. Okay. So guys, any doubt till this point? So guys, today we have done the basics of the OSI model. Okay. So guys, if you have any doubt, just tell me, I can explain everything. Any doubt, guys? Total how many classes in this course? Maybe 45 or, sorry, not 45. The total course will be around 45 days. Okay, so we will be having some week off also. So around 20 classes or 25 classes. Okay. 20-25 classes. Okay, what is DCE in the physical layer? So we have two things in the physical layer. Okay, not in the physical layer, that is a part of a serial link. Okay, one is DCE, one is DTE. Okay, Asif. So what is DTE? Let me explain you. DTE and DCE. So we use DTE on the customer edge, and the DCE we use on the provider edge. So the provider will set a clock. Okay, so that's basically, that is your speed. Okay, so a provider can set a clock and set a speed on the DCE link. Okay, so whenever we get a connection from the ISP, okay, so basically the ISP will decide the DCE. Okay, but we never use a serial link. Okay, so this is now we never use these things. Okay, only on the serial link we can use this thing. Only on serial links we can use DTE and DCE. Okay. On modem we can say on modem we use yes we can say. Because that like the ISP will be having a modem to set these things, okay. Okay, tomorrow we will start discussing the TCP IP model, okay. So guys, any doubt till this point? Okay, so for today we have done, okay. Now we will start tomorrow. At what time? Tomorrow guys, I will try to start the session at 10, okay, definitely. But for the timing I will confirm you, don't worry. I think all of you are comfortable around 10 and 12, right? So we can start, no problem. Okay guys, then bye. Meeting ID will be different for every day. Yes, meeting ID will be different for every day. Yeah. CSMA CD. Yes, we can discuss. Just remind me, okay? I will discuss, don't worry. Guys, as I told you, if you have any other like protocols, any other doubts, so yes, you can tell me. I will surely discuss everything. Everything I will discuss, okay? All the doubts I will clear. 12 tomorrow is right. For the timings, I will try to start at 10. Okay, but if I'll change the timing, I will text you, don't worry, in the group, okay? Just check the update in the group, okay? Okay, guys, bye, take care. The OSI model in 1970s, in the later 1970s, okay? Yeah. Any other doubt, guys? Guys, if you have any doubt, just tell me, I can explain. So guys, any other doubt? You can share your number also. I will add you in the group. Just share your number. Okay, I will surely add. Guys, any other doubt? Okay, so tomorrow we'll continue at 10. Okay, bye guys.